So good evening, guys. I am your teacher for now. I am Michelle P. Osal, but you can call me Teacher M. So today we're going to tackle. I'm going to teach you a graphing on how to graph a positive and a negative, and of course, because our topic is math technique, so I'm gonna show you what is the technique on graphing. So let us see. Of course, we all know the basic mathematics, and that is the addition, subtraction, and division, also the multiplication. So in our topic today, all the basic mathematics was included. Of course, that is part of a math. So, okay. So today we're going to make a graph. So, what is the form in graphing? So, say a graph. This is the graph, see? And this is the. We're going to make a cross line like this. The horizontal part, this is the x-axis, and a vertical in a vertical line is the y-axis. So that is our unfinished graph, and then we're going to put a dot on the center. So that is the center. So our graph look like this now. And then we had the technique on graphing. We had to identify the four quadrants. So what is the four quadrants? Yes, of course. Four quadrants. In graphing, it consists a four quadrants. That is start with a right line. It is a first quadrant, then followed by the left part, the second quadrant, and then the lower part of a second quadrant is the third quadrant, and then the last quadrant is, we call it the fourth quadrant. So this is our graph look like now. And then second technique is, we had to identify the negative and the positive, or the combination of negative and positive quadrants. So in the first quadrant is, what do you think is the sign of the first quadrant? Positive or negative? In the first quadrant, it is a positive. This is positive quadrant. And then followed by the second quadrant is the. Of course, you're correct. Is the positive and is a negative and positive quadrant. So negative and positive. And then in third quadrant, of course, if we put positive in the first quadrant, positive and negative on the second quadrant, of course, in the third quadrant, it is all negative. Then lastly, in the fourth quadrant, it is a positive and a negative. So as you observe, guys, if you look at my graph, so the technique in this, for you able not to suffering on because of this sign. So all you need to remember is, the first quadrant is composed of positive. Then if first quadrant is composed of positive, it should be followed by a negative and a positive. Then a third quadrant, if we put negative and positive in a second quadrant, of course in the third quadrant it is all negative. Then in the fourth quadrant, composed of, if it is negative, so you observe in the first quadrant it is all positive, then followed by a negative and positive, in the third quadrant is all negative. Of course in quadrant four, it follows by positive and negative. So observe in the second quadrant, the first sign is negative, and then the fourth quadrant, the first sign is positive. So if you are going to cross multiply the graph, it is look like this. The x. Below the line, it is a positive and a negative. So it is that is the difference.
So I'm gonna show you an example on graphing. So let us put here a negative 3 and a positive 2. That is our given number. So we're going to make a cross line, that is, and we're going to put a center. Remember, first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, and a fourth quadrant. So where do you think is the negative 3 should be put? Yes, you're right, in a second quadrant. So where is the negative 3? So we're going to make a dot, and the second one is positive 2. Of course, in the first quadrant there is a positive 2. So we should put here a label, so it should be connected to negative 3 and positive 2. So we're going to put a dot. Here is the dot. So as you observe, it is connected with a negative 3. We're going to put a line, it's connected with a negative 3, and then also a positive 2. Next example, it's going to put a 2 given variables. Positive 5 and positive 3. Next one is 7. There is 3 given number here. Don't you worry, it's still possible. So again, make a cross. Then put the center and then label it all. So this is now our unfinished. So we're going first to find the graph of this, the negative 4 and a positive 2. It is easy to define because we already know where is the quadrant of a negative 4. So of course, here, 4. So, and here, and the partner of this is a positive 2. So here, 4, negative 4. Of course, are going to graph again, put a dot. Make sure it left it labeled to negative 4 and a positive 2. If we're going to connect each other. So the second one is positive 5 and a positive 3. Of course, there's a label. So in the first quadrant, we're going to put all of this in the first quadrant. So a positive 3. 3 and a positive 5 and a positive 3. So here. Then the last one is a positive 3 and a negative 5. So we're going to find a positive 3. So in the first quadrant, positive 3 and a negative 5. Positive 3. So there is also a negative here, so we're going to put all of this here. Quadrant. So positive 3 and negative 5. So this is all our graph now. So I'm gonna connect this, this, and this. Five negative and the positive 3. So this our finished product. So thank you for listening, and I hope you enjoy. If you have some question, you may comment in the comment section below. So I hope you learned, guys, and thank you for watching. Oh wait, just remember the four basic steps on how to graph. First is you have to make a cross line, and then you have second one is you have to identify a quadrant, and the third one is you have to identify a sign. Make sure that you are not going to tumble your face. And the last one is